Hey everybody, we're in beautiful downtown Woodland, Washington. The world headquarters of Angler West, right? This is where the story's at. And Jason has been here a long time, done a really great job. He got a really good job with the county. So he's moved on, but no problem. We've got Charissa here. Meet Charissa. Charissa is going to be taking care of you, both here in the store and then also any online orders, or if you call the shop. She's the one that's going to be helping out. She's been doing a great job. No problem. We're running smooth here. So anyway, I just want to take you real quickly through the store. We got a bunch of new product, a bunch of new stuff. Oh, here's a guy going fishing right here. There you go. But and you know what? The boats. After I take you to the store, I'm going to show you. There's boat parking here, which is really something I really like about this location. We used to be just over there, and it was not good for parking, but got good parking here. So I'm going to take you through the store here and show you a few things. So right here, believe it or not, we're the world's largest Max lure dealer. We've got more Max than any other single store, according to Max. And so, you know, all the smile blades and humdingers and, you know, the old chest tackle stuff, and sling blades and the new scent flash flashers. We've got really an extensive selection of all that stuff. And then I just got in a whole big order of the spin doctors, including some private label ones. Spin Doctor or Dreamweaver has about 300 and something colors of the spin doctors. These things are huge over in like Lake Michigan and the Great Lakes area. Everybody uses these. And I wanted some pink ones, but they don't even make pink. It's like they just don't do pink back there. So they made up this, pink and moon jelly, which is the kind of identical to my private label fish flash here. So these are just, this is a really good color combination for around here. So I'm glad to have these. And right now I only have them in the 8-inch, but get 10-inch, 12-inch, and 6-inch. And so hopefully I'll have these in the other colors fairly soon. And of course, got all the fish flash, got a lot of Yakima stuff, rooster tails, spinning glows. And then a pretty good selection of Brad's stuff, the super baits, cut plugs, full-size super baits and wobblers, killer fish. And then I'll also carry this ghost thread, which if you're wrapping killer fish, the ghost thread is way more cost-effective and better quality than some of the other threads. And we got bait, got tray bait, frozen bait, cured baits, and then Washington coon shrimp. The reason I carry Washington coon shrimp is because it's the best stuff, no doubt about it. Then I got, all the hooks and terminal tackle, fish field, gum gut to Spro, a lot of really good high quality terminal tackle, and plenty of the cushets, Invisa swivels, sabiki rigs. I got a million sabiki rigs here, and they're not expensive. And if you're like on a buoy 10 and you want to catch some live anchovies for bait, here you go. Just get a couple of these, drop them down. You can get all the bait you want when the anchovies are in there, which they usually are. And we got weights, all the fish field jigs. These have been selling pretty well. I think people have been having good luck with these. They call them the blue water slayage heads. And an interesting head here that's been doing real well. And of course, the new fish field kokanee jigs. Some tuna guys are rigging these up a little heavier and using them for tuna now. And the Pacific chovy heads. We've got all the jigs, swim baits, tons and tons of swim baits. Oh, that's a good one there. Look at that. And then over on this side, we've got a really good selection of pro cure. This is all the best selling stuff from around this area. And then I got all the bait wax. That really, really sells well. That's good stuff. And then the rooster tail scent spray. The shrimp stuff. I was fishing the other day with a Castmaster and spraying this on my, I was putting the bait wax on and then kind of heavy. And then every once in a while, every few casts, I'd spray a little bit of shrimp on there, and that fish were really loving that. Well, and I got restocked on these fish handlers from Dreamweaver. Those are a really cool deal. The bait helmets, the little organ tackle stuff, the School of Fish, the spinners, got the VIP spinners, real high quality spinners, got the line locks. These things sell like crazy. If you're using 360 flashers at all, these line locks are the best, you know, few dollar investment you can make. Got the Ray stuff and the Castmasters, pretty good selection of Castmasters, little Cleos, and the Fishfield Hoochies, real good high quality Hoochies, and the inserts too. That's a good way to go. Oh, and then the fillet mats. Whoa, we saw a lot of these fillet mats. The Pro Fillet and the boards also. But these fillet mats, by far and away, the best mat, I think, on the market. But especially, you know, the kokanee guys are really buying these a lot. They're just perfect. You can fillet bigger fish on them too, but they're just awesome for kokanee. And then, oh, we haven't got this set up yet, but I just got in all the Max Prop Savers, all the different sizes. So, you know, of course, this keeps your prop from being damaged by, you know, hitting a rock or a log or something. And also, you know, I always had one of these on my motor and I was fishing down the Sacramento River. Not so much because I'm going to hit rocks or anything, but to keep the lines out of your prop. You know, that to me is a bigger deal usually, you know, in that river anyway. Because nothing worse than getting that line wrapped around, you know, your boat turns and you got a couple people in the boat and they not really paying attention. Yeah. So that'll keep the line out of your prop, which is a big deal. Got some waders, Fishfield waders, and P-line tools, and the Fishfield lure wraps, and then a pretty good selection of Yamamoto stuff. Real high quality bass baits, and other thing, you know, other species too, but of course Yamamoto's a big deal in the bass world. A lot of Senkos, and you know, just kind of the right stuff that I think I've picked out for this area in particular. And for California, you know, on the website, sell a lot in California. Got the P-line laser minnows and predator baits here, P-line lines and the Oregon tackle unibobber sinkers. These have been very, very popular. And fish field floats, and we got the beads, pretty good selection of thirsty beads, and the B&R beads, some brads, and then the steely bugs from Oregon tackle. They've really, yeah, this right here is, you know, for steelhead and so forth. I mean, for steelhead, right, if you're not using these beads and you're kind of missing out. And got the mag lips from Yakima and the Spro jigs. These are going to be a big deal here pretty quick when the coho come in. Hey, look, it's Jason. Hey, you come in. Hey, Jason, how you doing?
How's it going?
All right, how's your new job going?
Love it.
All right, on. Love cool. It. Yeah, no, that's good. It's awesome. Yeah, no, I'm glad, you know, Jason was really a good employee here. But he's got a great job with the county now, so that's good for him. Yeah. And then the Spro stuff. If you're into bass fishing at all, walleye, this is really high quality stuff. Oh, and then the rock stars. Of course, the Spro rock stars also. So but anyway, what I'm going to do, I'm going to take you around outside the building. Yeah, I'm going to show you where you can park your boat. There's a public parking lot. So you can just drive right in here, go up in the public parking lot. Lots of parking back here, and there's plenty of room for boats. So, and it's right here by the pond, you know, Horseshoe Lake, which has fish in it. You know, a lot of people fish there. So, you know, Woodland's like, you know, one of the historical centers of the fishing universe, really. And that's true. I mean, there's a few places like that around the world that have been really important historically to development sport fishing, and Woodland is definitely one of them. You got, you know, of course, G. Loomis right over here in Lima Glass across the I-5, and you know, brands like Fenwick, Sage, Sage, and several others. You know, you trace the roots back to Woodland. You know, it's because all the great fishing around here. So, you know, some of that's changed now. But anyway, here's a big parking lot, plenty of room for your boat, and you just pull through. You don't have to turn around or anything. It just goes straight through that way, and you're right back on the main road. Back on the freeway. Now we've been open in the mornings from 7 to noon, but now starting Monday we're gonna open 12 to 5. And so Charissa will be here to help you out 12 to 5. And I'm here quite a bit too, unless I'm out filming somewhere. So please pull off exit 21 and come check out the store and say hi to Charissa, and I'm sure we can help you catch more fish.